RNG is a very mysterious topic for game designers. Most games have RNG, but there's a group of players that hates it with the intensity of a thousand suns. Randomness is obviously unbalanced and unfair. So why is it in almost every game then? I promise this is really, really interesting, and it might even make you a better gamer, a better game dev, a better person, or a better lover. Maybe none of these things, maybe all of these things. Anyway, please enjoy this video and grab yourself a bucket. Here are somewhere between 8 and 12 reasons why RNG is so prevalent in games. Right off the gate, here's a wild one. It gives players a scapegoat. Games are lies. Game devs trick you into having fun by pretending you're a fantasy hero in a fantasy world or something. And a part of that lie is to design when to confront you with your failures and when to hide them from you. If you lose at chess, it proves beyond any doubt that your opponent played that round of chess better than you. But if you lose at Warcraft and they found all the class of attack and the Book of the Dead, really that was quite unfair. A lot of players think removing the RNG from a game would benefit them personally. Let that sink in. This is obviously false. RNG does not favor anyone. This shows that RNG works as a scapegoat. And if you ever found a gamer who always has bad luck, or if you ever felt like that, the trick worked. But it's nothing to feel bad about. It's what it's supposed to do. Let's stay with player psychology for a moment. Good games are often games we want to come back to. And this is something that is designed into them. Daily rewards, for example, are there to keep you coming back. But having enough RNG is a powerful mechanic to motivate the player to play another round right after, or the next day. After bad RNG, you know the next round must be better. And after good RNG, you are on a roll. RNG produces stories of epic wins and harsh defeats. When you're ahead, you are never sure if RNG does not sabotage you. When you are behind, you have always a chance for a comeback you might never forget. And when these big comebacks happen, they really can stick with you for years. But it also adds smaller events to a match that make the game more fun to talk about. And players talking about your game is very, very valuable. It is not unbalanced and it is not unfair. Where RNG being bad for competitive play and fairness may be the most common complaint of frustrated players. They are factually wrong. Not only does everyone have the same odds, enough randomness is basically mathematically guaranteed to even out in the long run. RNG is not the reason your rank is so low in Hearthstone. Your draws and discovers even out over 10 rounds. And you played 30 today. It can be faked. That's one of the best things about it. We are back to games being lies, you remember? When a game says the odds are 50%, have you ever measured it? From a game design perspective, there's often no reason to give the real odds. Generally, players misjudge how their randomness feels. So for a displayed 20% chance of critting to feel correct, maybe it actually should crit 30% of the time. On the other hand, a 10% chance of getting critically hit should maybe only be 5%. Games can decide that the player gets lucky. Players like getting lucky, so why not give it to them? Especially when the true odds are frustrating. It keeps players from overthinking the maths. With randomness, players can't anxiously stare at all the maths trying to think 20 turns ahead. At some point, this cloud of probability splits into sub cases and they give up and finally take some risks, which is where the fun is. It adds dimensions to an otherwise plain number. Dealing 5 damage is very different from dealing 1 to 11 damage. In some cases, it is objectively stronger. In some cases, it is objectively weaker. But in every case, it just feels different. It helps transport the difference between a reliable old club on the head and a pointy spear, or between a planned retreat and a last second dodge roll. Not all things can be broken down in the middle. The game can't give players 3.4% of a legendary sword each encounter. Just sometimes getting the sword feels so much better. Often randomness is a way to simplify behavior that otherwise would be much more complicated to explain. And keep in mind, you are always free to make it less random and secret when you need guarantees. And here's maybe my favorite point. RNG smooths breaking points. Imagine you have 100 zerglings and they all attack 100 dudes. Each zergling deals 9 damage, but each dude has 10 HP. It makes no difference if your zerglings deal 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9 damage. You will need 2 hits per dude. This is kinda weird and often unwanted in games. And it gets even weirder. If you get an attack upgrade that gives you +2 damage, you now deal 11. And you only need a single hit, which means you double your damage by getting +2 damage. If we switch our zerglings to deal 7 to 11 instead, it suddenly has a 40% chance to kill. And each damage you gain adds 20%. Each point of damage you lose removes 20% chance to kill. It is so much smoother. Are you hoping for a number 10? I'm sorry, bad RNG. But if you like RNG, you should take a look at our very random game Backpack Battles. It has a free demo and you can see our approach to randomness firsthand.